Hey everybody, I'm Chris Wook. We've heard a lot of great things about RHA's T10 series, and the switchable filter tips especially were just too cool to pass up. We just had to take a look at them ourselves. The box carrying the RHA T10s gives you a good look at nearly everything inside, not just the headphones. Opening it up, you'll find the headphones, a metal plate holding a surprisingly large amount of different size tips, two pairs of filters to adjust the tone, more on these later, a clothing clip, carrying case, and finally, the manual. The T10s only come in one color option, the slightly industrial looking metal build that you're seeing right now. Luckily, this is a very nice look with a simple elegance that is hard to ignore. These headphones are advertised as being handmade, and it's clear that a lot of care has been put into both the design and construction. The T10s are slightly on the heavy side. This didn't bother me during testing, though it might be an issue for others. The cable can be routed around the top of your ear, which is how I wore them, and this kept them out from falling out or moving around while I was in motion. I found them very comfortable, free of the strain that can be an issue with other in-ears. The included carrying case is a semi-hard shell design with plenty of room for the headphones and even extra tips and filters should you want to carry them with you. As we're looking at the T10 model in this review, the only connectivity option is a plain cable. No mic or remote are included. That said, if you're using an iOS device or an Android user who's happy with single button functionality, the T10i model adds a microphone and standard 3-button remote. One of the most unique aspects of the RHA T10s are the filters that allow you to tune the audio to your preference simply by screwing them into each earbud, replacing the section that the tips slide onto. We'll get to these in a moment, but here are impressions of the T10s using the standard reference filter. Bass is solid, representing the lows without adding any mud. This is somewhat expected due to the size, but as frequencies dipped under 80 Hz, they seem to roll off slightly, though the frequency curve on the box doesn't show this. Mids are excellent, guitars sound great, and vocals, both male and female, spoken and sung, have plenty of depth and presence. Highs provided plenty of detail on cymbals and hi-hats without ever getting harsh, even on recordings that sound harsh on other headphones. To be honest, I wasn't expecting much out of the filters, but I was surprised at how well they worked. They are subtle, but they definitely are effective too. The bass filter adds some oomph to the lows, correcting the perceived dip I mentioned earlier, but to my surprise, they didn't sacrifice any high-end detail. The treble filter doesn't pull the legs out from the bass by any means, but I found that for modern music, it did seem to be slight overkill, making highs sound kind of harsh. For older recordings though, particularly jazz, it did a great job of adding sheen to dull-sounding mixes. If you don't care about a remote, or if you use Android, the T10 should be on your list of sub-$200 in-ears. If you use an iPad or iPhone, the T10i should be on that list instead. Either way, they deserve to be on there because this is a great sounding pair of headphones and absolutely worth a look. We're giving the RHA T10 series an 8.8 out of 10. And that's it for this one, everybody. For all the details, check out the full review over at soundguys.com. A link is down in the description. So is a link to buy the headphones if you're interested, and buying from that link helps support the channel. If you liked the video, let us know, and don't forget to subscribe. I'm Chris Wook. Thanks for watching.